Welcome, everybody, to this edition of Attention Talk Video. I'm your host, ADHD and Attention Coach Jeff Copper. And today we're here to talk about ADHD and emotion. We've done another video on what is emotion, sharing clips from an interview that I did with Dr. Russell Barkley on Attention Talk Radio. Today we're here back with another clip that was part of the same show that we originally did. In the first video, we defined really kind of what emotion was and the two-step process, the two-level process, and the challenge of the second level of those with ADHD to kind of catch their emotion, engage it, and override it. Today, we're going to pay a clip of six steps that Dr. Barkley talks about fundamentally that can help you. Number one, ADHD medications can help you regulate the situation. He talks about situational deployment, attention deployment, and some others. So we're going to run the tape, and when we come back, we'll talk about it a little bit to kind of summarize it in a little bit of coaching terms. So let's roll the tape.
Dr. Barkley, can you talk about the six things, the six areas that result of this that can help?
Yes, I think that if we think about these six things, they're going to make sense once I explain them to you. So bear with me here. It could take me just a minute or two to get all of this out. But step number one is realize that the ADHD medications may help manage some of these emotional difficulties. Not all of them, but some of them. For instance, if the emotional part of the brain is not being regulated properly by this frontal lobe, and your ADHD medications are going into these areas and increasing the ability of the frontal lobe to manage the emotional system, you might find that your ADHD medications are beneficial to this impulsive part of emotion, this quickness with which the emotion is up and out and not inhibited. Now, as I explained at the CHAD conference, the different ADHD medications will do this through different means. They don't all do it identically, and they don't all do it well. So just understand that you may need to talk with your physician if you're on medication about, is this the right medication for managing the emotional piece of it? And if you're not on medication or you're considering going on it, keep in mind that this might be one of the advantages of the medication. It's not just that it helps you concentrate or that it helps you to be less impulsive and less hyperactive. It may also help you regulate your emotions and keep you from showing these impulsive emotions. So number one, ADHD meds can help benefit certain parts of this emotional problem that people with ADHD have. Now, the other five things are psychological strategies that anybody can use, whether they're on medication or not. And they go back to the four stages of an emotion that we talked about right at the top of the show, Jeff.
Uh-huh.
For instance, we talked about the fact that an emotion begins with a situation. Something happens. Well, step two in managing your emotions is to select the right situation and don't put yourself in situations that are likely to provoke strong emotions. Don't just go about your life being pulled hither and yon without any particular forethought or plan in mind. If you know, for instance, that a particular setting, a particular context, maybe there's a particular bar that you like to go to after work on Fridays for happy hour, but you know that that's a problem for you because there's a couple of people there that you don't get along with and that you usually tend to get in arguments with these people, you know, don't go to that bar. Find a different place to have your beer and your happy hour. In other words, select the situation so that it doesn't provoke the emotions that you know are going to occur in alternative situations that you could have gone into. Now, you can't always do that, but many times you can, especially if you've repeatedly encountered problems in that situation. Then step one is don't go there. Avoid that situation if at all possible. So we call this situation selection, and it is step one in managing your emotional health.
Okay.
Step two is, what happens if I find myself in a situation where I'm becoming emotional? Okay, I wasn't able to select myself out of this. I find myself here. What do I do? This is where we modify the situation. We change the structure of the situation. For instance, you and I were talking about being in a business meeting where I may have said something that was very insulting or humiliating to you. One of the things that you can do in a situation like that is to look away from the individual, sit away from that individual, turn and look at somebody else and start talking to them, push your chair back away from the table, perhaps stand up, go to the coffee machine, get a coffee, come back into the room again, so that you can modify the structure of that situation by where you sit, by where you look, and by what you choose to do that might help to calm that emotion down a little bit before you react to what the other person has said. So change the situation. Sometimes you can also change it by simply leaving, as you heard me just say. Just buy yourself some time. Get a break. You know, a one-minute break to get a drink of water is not an insult to anybody. And then after you got that, you can come back in. But it gives you that 1 to 2 minutes to get a hold of yourself and get back in the situation. Now, the next thing that you can do after situation modification is how you deploy your attention, what you think about and where you look. So, as we said, you can divert your eyes away from the person who's upsetting you. You can close your eyes if you need to. You can turn and look out the window. You can look at a piece of art in the room and, you know, try to analyze your feelings about the art. But get your attention system away from the provocative event itself. And we call that attention deployment, where you deploy your attention to something different than what is provoking the emotion. Mm-hmm. So to repeat, we've got situation selection, choosing situations that are healthy for you rather than ones that lead to emotional difficulties. The second is modifying the situation. And the third is changing what you're attending to, what you're looking at. Now, let's suppose none of that works. All right, well, the next thing we call cognitive change, and I know you use this a lot in your business as well, and this is where how you think about the emotion can literally change the emotion. This is where you evaluate whether this is really an important event or not to you. You might say to yourself, for instance, in the situation you and I had set up where, you know, I've said something insulting, you might say to yourself, well, this guy's not important to me. What the heck does he know what he's talking about?
Yep.
You know, he's just another guy in the room, and he's not my boss, and who does he think he is anyway? I mean, these are self-statements you can be saying in your head that can help calm you down, because you're going to reappraise the situation in its importance to make it less important than it may have seemed at the beginning. So there's a cognitive element to this where, as you know, your emotions are partly determined by what you think.
Yep.
And if you alter your thoughts, you literally can alter the consequent emotions that come out of that. And then finally, the last step in this process is where you modify the emotion itself. It's already overtaken you. There's not much you can do about it. You can't leave the situation. So now what you can do, focus on your breathing. If you've ever had any sort of meditation training, and it doesn't have to be religious or Buddhist meditation, just standard meditation training, or even if you've had practice in what we call deep muscle relaxation, you'll remember the old Jacobson muscle relaxation techniques where you focus on your breathing, you focus on your heart rate, you tense and relax different muscle groups, and by doing that, you can begin to de-stress the situation and maybe temper the emotion. Now, what's important here, Jeff, to understand is that the later in this sequence you wait, the harder it is to do it and the less successful it's likely to be.
Absolutely.
You're better off choosing your situations wisely. Remember, we talked about situation selection. Than you are trying to modify the strong emotion once it's already out of you. So the earlier in this whole sequence of steps we've talked about, the better. So to repeat, you've got six things to do. One, check out the right medications, make sure you're on the right ones, and see if they help with your emotions. Two, choose situations wisely. If you know that a situation gets you in trouble emotionally, try to avoid it. Three, if you can't, modify that situation in some way so that it's less emotional for you. Where you sit, who you talk to, who you look at, and so on. Next one, make sure you deploy your attention properly. As you've said at the beginning of the show, it's what you pay attention to. And if you divert your attention away from the emotional provoking event, that'll help. Next, reappraise the importance of the situation for yourself. Hopefully that will downregulate the emotion. And then finally, if you have to, do some stress management, deep muscle relaxation, little meditation to address the emotion itself.
Dr. Barclay, what's I really like about this, and again, providing this platform as we talk to the top, the idea of taking a look at ADHD with emotion starts to explain so much that our prior models didn't. It just seems to kind of line up, and what I really like here is what you've described. These things that you've talked about, almost every one of them I can link to something that as an ADHD coach we're trying to do. We're trying to teach people how to kind of calm down, how to pause, and different structures in order for them to shift their attention. So when they walk into a situation, they go, wait a second, I can feel the stress, I can feel the emotion come up, I'm pausing, I'm catching myself, this is how I normally react. These are the types of things that I do need to do in order that have successfully calmed me down the past in order to control or redirect their behavior. And it's fascinating because just the way you've lined this up, it really, really kind of links in with a lot of coaching theories and a lot of things or tools that we do to kind of help facilitate this process.
Yes, it absolutely does. And as you know, this isn't just a good model for managing emotion. It's a good model for managing yourself, period. Even whether or not the situation involves emotions, these are just good self-control strategies that all of us can and should be using. And by making them more explicit, hopefully we allow people to capitalize on them even better.
That Dr. Barclay, he's really, really pretty fascinating. He did outline six steps in the process of managing your emotions. And at the end of it, he talked about the further you get down the line, the more difficult it is to do something about it and to get yourself out of it. So the awareness of emotions is really, really important. The awareness of how you manage it and downregulate is really, really important. And it's really important trying not to get into these situations. The one thing that is ubiquitous about emotion is that it starts with awareness. It really is the individual has to catch themselves and inhibit and override it, and actually have to be thinking in advance, where are those situations where I could go into and I could get me into trouble? If I do have to go in those situations, what mindset do I need to have to go in there? I've worked with some people where they're going to go into it, a situation where they know they're going to have some emotional challenges, and they have a mindset they try to get into so that they don't let the triggers kind of hit them. There's also little tricks while you're in it or what you do to downregulate it. I know that I've had some people that were all the way at the bottom where they were really struggling, and they stop, they breathe, and different things work for different people. I've had people stick their head in ice water. Some people doodle, play the piano, exercise vigorously for a period of time, all those things to kind of catch themselves and downregulate it. But those steps that Dr. Barclay are ubiquitous. And I think that it's worth knowing them and becoming conscious of them and really trying to be forward thinking as much as you can in order to manage them. We have a lot of other videos at Attention Talk Video that deals with emotional self-regulation. Fight, Flight, or Freeze is one that we did. We talked a couple with Melissa Orlov around relationships and others. So we encourage you to search Attention Talk Video and YouTube and emotion, and you'll find other tips and tricks on that. The purpose of doing this video is it really starts with an understanding and an awareness, and I think Dr. Barclay did a great job of that. In the link below, there's a link to the original video in case you stumbled on this first, really defining what an emotion is. So with that, we hope you've enjoyed this, you've got some insight. Please subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Leave some comments, we always enjoy that. And with that, we hope you've enjoyed this edition of Attention Talk Video. Take care.